Hi, my name is Blaine Felloney, call sign COCO, and I'm the commanding officer of the United States Navy Fighter Weapons School, better known as TOPGUN. Now, TOPGUN was founded back in 1969 in direct response to the unacceptable combat losses over the skies of Vietnam. The American kill ratio was a dismal 2-to-1. So for context, that's down from 14-to-1 in World War II and 12-to-1 in Korea. Now, in response, the Navy tasked Captain Frank Ault to investigate what was the root cause of that poor U.S. fighter performance and to identify solutions with an explicit directive to triple the American kill ratio as quickly as possible. Now, his findings were published in the reports of the Air-to-Air Missile System Capability Review, better known as the Ault Report. And in it, Captain Ault identified deficiencies in acquisition, in maintenance, as well as a noted loss of aircrew expertise in the air-to-air arena. And to counter this last and most critical issue, Captain Ault recommended the formation of a graduate-level Navy Fighter Weapons School. And as a result, TOPGUN was founded. And its 9 founding members looked to establish a cadre of highly skilled and highly trained individuals that would ultimately return to their fleet squadrons as tactics instructors. And those 9 founding members had a very clear mission statement: to win in combat and to turn the tide of the war in Vietnam. Now, that initial cadre of TOPGUN instructors thought that the mindset of this schoolhouse would pay dividends under the pressures of actual combat, and they actually didn't have to wait long to find out. Just 1 year after the graduation of the first TOPGUN class, Lieutenant Jerry Boulier, who was a graduate of the first TOPGUN course, was launched from USS Constellation on an Alert 5. Now, Boulier and his flight lead were quickly vectored onto 2 MiG-21 aircraft. However, both F-4 Phantoms had inoperable radars, which negated their ability to employ beyond visual range. So they had to maneuver to the visual arena, and from there it was Boulier who picked up Tally first. He took the tactical flight lead and then maneuvered to a weapons employment envelope. From there, he fired 2 AIM-9D Sidewinders and downed a single MiG-21 aircraft, making him the first Top Gun graduate MiG killer. And what's interesting is when he was asked about the fight that day, Boulier said it was just like training in Whiskey 291 with Top Gun. And that legacy that he started that day would continue throughout the remainder of the Vietnam War, with an additional 8 either Top Gun graduates or Top Gun instructors downing enemy aircraft. And the single most impressive statistic is the American kill ratio rose back to 12-to-1. And that was a validation to the impact that Top Gun had on the fleet. And while it is an absolute privilege to wear this patch, it's also a burden that every patch wearer now carries for the rest of their lives, because it affects everything you do. From now on, how I prepare, how I brief, fight my aircraft, and teach in the debrief, I understand it is going to be viewed through the lens of something bigger and more important than myself, because we all now represent Top Gun. And by extension, that is the generations of warfighters that have worn this Top Gun patch before us. And it's incumbent on us to maintain the credibility and the professionalism that this patch represents. Now, the primary mission of Top Gun has remained unchanged since 1969. It's very simple: to win in combat. Top Gun is a unique organization in that, based on the history, the credibility, and the impact it has had on naval aviation, we have been afforded a certain amount of autonomy. Number one, there is no quota of patch wearers for us to fill. Since the inception of Top Gun back in 1969, we've been able to set the standard, and we hold every person that comes through the Top Gun course accountable to meet those standards. Now, we as a staff will do everything we can to get them the extra repetitions of briefs, simulators, and flights. But at the end of the day, if you do not meet the standard, we're not going to lower the bar, and you will not graduate, and you will not get a Top Gun patch. Number two, we're able to pick our replacements, and we're able to pick from a pool of individuals that are highly qualified to come to the Top Gun staff. We look for talent. You have to be credible in the aircraft. We look for passion. You have to have the work ethic, and you have to truly invest yourself in this job. And then we look for the personality, not only amongst these individual staff members, but you have to have the personality to interact with the fleet as well. The 34 staff members that make up the Top Gun staff understand that we stand on the shoulders of giants. And it is our responsibility now to make sure that the credibility and the professionalism of this schoolhouse is upheld. And these 34 staff members pour their heart and their souls into this job. To be a Top Gun instructor these days, they are working directly with engineers, software developers, and acquisition professionals, making sure fully informed decisions are being made so naval aviation continues into the fight in the future. They're becoming subject matter experts on either blue hardware, tactics and execution, or adversary, and they pour months of study into becoming that single source or that belly button for naval aviation. Additionally, they're working with defense contractors, and they're getting all the pertinent information and rolling that into our ability to constantly evolve our tactics, our techniques, and our procedures. Bottom line, I am proud of the principles that Top Gun was founded on, and would have kept Top Gun at the pinnacle of tactical aviation for over 55 years. I'm proud of the staff that work day in and day out to maintain the credibility of this organization and the credibility of the patch. And I am proud to play a small role in what is the United States Navy Fighter Weapons School.